I'd like to call the Gurnee Village Board regular meeting of March 6, 2017 to order. Roll call, please, Andy.
Bomas.
Present.
Hood.
Here.
Wilson.
Here.
Ross.
Here.
Garner.
Here.
Thorstenson.
Here.
Six present.
All right, thank you. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, welcome, everybody. Same faces as we had a few minutes ago. First up is public comment. I would like to personally thank Jack for outstanding work on our volunteer fair, which is kind of a concept idea that him and I talked about in passing. He ran with it, implemented it, and it was just overwhelming to see the response from the organizations and all the residents that showed up looking for opportunities to give back to their community. It was really, many of us had tears in our eyes. It really was heartwarming, and people are asking us to do it again and get a bigger location, and so it really was just a huge home run, so thank you, Jack. No other public comment? All right, then I'm going to move on to the approval of the consent agenda as presented.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Garner.
Second.
Second by Trustee Thorstenson. Roll call, please, Andy.
Bomas.
Aye.
Hood.
Yes.
Wilson.
Aye.
Ross.
Aye.
Garner.
Aye.
Thorstenson.
Yes.
Six aye.
Motion carries. Patrick, please read the consent agenda into the record.
Item number one, approval of the minutes from the February 20th, 2017 Village Board meeting. At number two, approval of Engineering Division's recommendation to award Richard A. Walton Village Plaza paver project to the low bidder Alana's Landscapes at a cost of $30,624. At number three, approval of Engineering Division's recommendation to award 2017 crack sling program to Patriot Pavement Maintenance at a cost not to exceed $75,000, the County Municipal League Cooperative Purchasing Program. At number four, approval of request to allow Economic Development Director Ellen Dean to attend the International Council of Shopping Centers Recon in Las Vegas, Nevada from May 21st through 24th, 2017 at a cost not to exceed $2,000. At number five, approval request to set bid date of March 24th, 2017 for the 2017 Network Equipment Project Number 1. At number six, approval payroll for period ending February 18, 2017 in the amount of $752,963.02. At number seven, approval of payroll transfer journal for period ending February 18, 2017, in the amount of $742,689.59. At number eight, approval of bills for period ending March 6, 2017, in the amount of $451,679.23.
Thank you, Patrick. Do I have a motion to approve the consent agenda as read into the record? Motion by Trustee Bomas, second by Trustee Ross. Roll call, please, Andy.
Bomas.
Aye.
Hood.
Yes.
Wilson.
Aye.
Ross.
Aye.
Garner.
Aye.
Thorstenson.
Yes.
Motion carries. Moving on, petitions and communications. First one is a proclamation for Women's History Month, March 2017. During Women's History Month, we reflect on both the struggles and the extraordinary accomplishments of women and honor their role in shaping the course of our nation's history. And American women of every culture, class, and ethnic background have made historic contributions to the growth and strength of our nation in countless recorded and unrecorded ways. American women have played and continue to play a critical economic, cultural, and social role in every sphere of life by constituting a significant portion of the labor force working inside and outside of the home, as well as a majority of the volunteer labor force. And American women have been leaders not only in securing their own rights of suffrage and equal opportunity, but also in the abolitionist movement, the emancipation movement, the industrial labor movement, the civil rights movement, and other movements, especially the peace movement, which sought to create a more fair and just society for all. And despite these contributions, the role of American women in history has been consistently overlooked and undervalued in the literature, teaching, and study of American history. and the village desires to join several other communities and organizations across the nation in recognizing the unique contributions and accomplishments of American women. Now let it therefore be proclaimed by the President and Board of Trustees of the Village of Gurnee that March 2017 will be designated as Women's History Month in the Village of Gurnee. Do you have a motion to approve?
So
motion by Trustee Balmas.
Second.
Second by Trustee Garner. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? All right. Women's History Month. Item number two is I'm recommending Ed Konecki to the Police Pension Board, and Ed is with us tonight. Ed currently serves on our Fire Pension Board and has graciously volunteered, since the village is already investing in continuing education courses that the pension board members must complete each year. He's volunteered to serve on both boards, and pension boards are not anything that even most of the community knows that we have, but they are responsible for a lot of money and oversight of some very important funds to the village and very important funds to our public safety officers. So I very much appreciate Ed agreeing to serve. Ed, would you like to say anything?
Yeah,
the microphone, because we taped this and put it on YouTube.
Well, first of all, I tell this story all the time. It's pretty funny. About the mayor reaching out to me to be on the fire pension board, and I was honored to do it. And after the council meeting, she came up to me and said, congratulations, you now have to complete 32 hours of continuing education. And I said, that would have been nice to know that beforehand, but we did it. And obviously you have to do 16 hours every year now for the fire pension board. So I said, why don't we, and the mayor said, do you know anybody that can do this for the police department? And I said, well, great idea, right? How about if I do it? I'm already doing the 16 hours anyways. And I think it makes sense. I actually asked today to see where we're at. We're up at $33 million as of Friday's close for the Fire Pension Board. So, and where we got in at, I don't know the exact number, but it's much better. Obviously, the markets cooperated very, very well with us. But very happy of where we got that with the holder that had it before and where we have it now. Highly diversified and a really good place. So it's been an honor to do that, and I'm looking forward to do that for the police department as well.
I appreciate it very, very much, as well as staff, that we have citizens that are willing to step forward and take on these little-known positions that really have a huge impact on the taxpayers in this community. So any questions for Ed? Do I have a motion to approve his nomination? Motion by Trustee Thorstensen, second by Trustee Ross. All in favor say aye. A roll call. Okay, roll call, Andy.
Balmas.
Aye.
Hood.
Yes.
Wilson.
Aye.
Ross.
Aye.
Garner.
Aye.
Thorstensen.
Yes.
6 aye.
All right, you're in.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, that's the end of petitions and communications. Do we have any reports?
No.
All right, any old business?
Not tonight.
All right, moving right on to new business. First up is an approval of a request from the police department to waive the formal bidding process and award the Communication Center workstation reconfiguration and carpet replacement project. I'm not even going to try.
Zybex.
Zybex at a total cost of $121,014.98.
Sure. So as part of the consolidation process, as well as change operationally as far as how they're handling calls in the dispatch center, we need to reconfigure some furniture. This will involve dismantling it, modifying it, and then reassembling it, so moving some stuff around. So while they're doing that, it also makes sense from our perspective to replace the carpet in the center. Both the carpet and the furniture layout is original, so it's from 2004. Zybex was who we used when we designed and installed everything in 2004, so we've worked with them since that time and made little tweaks here and there. Always been pleased with the equipment that they provide, and as well as the service levels. As they were the original installer and we had the relationship with them, we believe from an operational perspective it makes sense to continue to work with them. So this project's actually going to be divided into two phases. So the first phase will be to reconfigure three workstations and do all the carpet, and then the second phase will be the remaining three workstations. So The state has consolidation grant funding available. So as part of this reconfiguration relates to consolidation, we have applied. Have we applied yet? Do we include? Okay, we have applied to be reimbursed to the state for phase one, which is $70,517.98. So we'll know in July whether we receive that funding or not. We didn't apply the whole amount because some of it is related to how we're changing operationally as far as answering calls and dispatching. So with that being said, we're looking to get this done now. Like we talked about in the budget presentation, we want to go live with Zion in July. So these changes need to take place before that. So we're looking to waive the formal bidding requirement and award this to Zyvex in the amount of 121,14.98. So, and there's appropriate fundings when you're marked in next year's proposed budget to handle this. So.
Questions for Pat?
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Balmus, second by Trustee Garner. Roll call, please. Andy?
Balmus.
Aye.
Hood?
Yes.
Wilson?
Aye.
Ross?
Aye.
Garner?
Aye.
Thorstenson?
Yes.
6-aye.
All right, motion carries. Next up is approval of ordinance 2017-10. Authorizing execution of a professional services agreement with Bollinger, Locke, and Associates for engineering services for the 2017 roadway rehabilitation program.
Yeah, a couple meetings ago, we awarded some engineering contracts, and I said that was kind of the first phase, and there would be another request coming before you. Well, this is that second request. This contract is for the roadway rehabilitation and water main project, so that's the reconstruction aspect. Looking to have contract personnel focus one focus on roads, the other one focus on the utility water aspect. So we've used Bollinger in the past, had very good results, and actually the two employees that they would be assigning to us for this construction season are known to us. We've worked with those employees in the past and been really happy with the work they provided. Looking the breakdown, I mean, it's about $160,000, $100,000 for the resident engineer for the pavement focus, $60,000 for the utility engineer for the water main focus. Since we've expanded the amount of funding that we have for infrastructure improvements, we knew that outside contractual assistance would be needed, so we've used that over the past couple of years. So this is a continuation of that with a firm that we've used in the past. They're a known quantity, and Scott's been really happy with the oversight they've provided out in the field.
Questions for Pat or Scott?
I'll make a motion to approve.
All right, motion by Trustee Balmus.
Second.
By Trustee Thorstenson. Roll call, please, Andy.
Balmus?
Aye.
Hood?
Yes.
Wilson?
Aye.
Ross?
Aye.
Garner?
Aye.
Thorstenson?
Yes.
6-aye.
All right, motion carries. This is a really smart investment getting these contractors. All right, motion carries. So item number three is a discussion of options to pursue STP grant funding to rehabilitate Almond Road. It's kind of a pros and cons to federal funding versus village funding. So Scott's gonna walk us through it.
Yep.
Oh, I'm walking through.
Yes.
Under the bus.
Start walking, Scott.
Okay, so the Village of Gurnee, last year we had identified that Almond Road in its entirety is starting to deteriorate. The road's built in 1993, more or less. So it's getting up to 25 years of age. We identified a need to resurface Almond Road. The pavement structure itself is in really good shape. We just got to basically put a new wearing surface on it. We were planning to work on Almond Road this year. Unfortunately, or fortunately, as the timing worked out well, we saw the Jawa project come through very quickly and decided to go down Almond Road with that. So we deferred on the roadway maintenance and pavement maintenance itself because with Jawa out there, we did not want to have two contractors playing in the same sandbox. That just never goes well for us. So we postponed working on the Almond Road project. In the meantime, we are looking to do next year. The roadway Jawa will be out of there. The road is still going to need to be resurfaced, and we were basically planning to invest, you know, about $1.5 million in replacing Almond Road in its entirety. That would be, you know, from Washington Street all the way up to Grand Avenue to put all new road wearing surface out there. We did identify that there is an opportunity out there for the Village of Gurnee to apply for what's called Surface Transportation Program grant funds, and that's through the Lake County Council. And we've talked to Civil Tech Engineering as one of our engineering consultants that's very proficient with that type of grant funding and evaluated the pros and cons of it, which I've outlined in my memo to the board. My primary concerns as the village engineer is that the dollars and cents of it pretty well weighs out there. You know, if we do it in-house, it's going to cost the Village of Gurnee's residents a little bit more money to do it out of pocket. If we go for the STP grant, we basically, there's no such thing as a free lunch is what I wrote in there. And we are then subject to all the federal requirements of that grant program. The timeline is not guaranteed. And at this point, we haven't even started looking at the project, so the scope of the work is not guaranteed. If we do it in-house, I know I can go out there, I can mill off the road, I can put a new road down, and we're going to be in and out of there very quickly. If we subject the project to federal grant funding, I don't know if there's going to be a major scope creep and or what the magnitude of that might be. In order to determine what the scope will be of this, we would have to invest about $250,000 up front in order to just figure out what the full scope of the project would be. And that is the contract proposal that we negotiated with Civil Tech Engineering. So just due to the significant amount of money involved here and the significant amount of risk involved here, I am very uncomfortable making a firm recommendation to the Board of Trustees on a direction to proceed. So I would request some guidance from the policy officials of the community to tell me what to do.
All right, let me be a little more blunt than Scott. He's very diplomatic. I think any federal funding right now is questionable with everything that's going on. And we're at their mercy whether we get it this year. Maybe we do, maybe we don't. That's a huge risk on a road that absolutely needs to be done. Our previous experience, my opinion, is we end up overbuilding a road because the federal requirements is one set for the whole United States and doesn't bear any resemblance to the individuality of different neighborhoods and how those roads are used. And there are strings attached, as Scott's, not trivializing that. That really, once you get into this, they start throwing other things at you and you are in it. I mean, these are tax dollars from our residents, whether it comes from federal tax dollars or our tax dollars. Our residents are still paying for this road, and they end up paying a whole lot more for the road than what we really need. But it is a board's decision as to which option we pursue. Questions, Trustee Thorstensen?
So a couple meetings ago, I think you were talking, and the mayor expressed your interest in making some type of intersection improvements at Data and Almond. Would this be part of it?
Would a roundabout be included with federal dollars?
Intersection improvement. Yes, we are looking at an intersection improvement at Almond and Data. Right now, we are primarily dialing into what's going to be called a mini roundabout. So it won't be a full-blown center median that you can't get over, but it'll be a mountable center median. We have incorporated that design into both options that were laid out there on the memo. The phase two design engineering, I think I had about $25,000 earmarked that would be specific to the intersection. The rest of the project is really just, start here, end here. There's really no plan, preparation, or design required for the rest of the project.
Follow up.
Thank you. One more question. So which amount was listed in our budget?
For the proposed budget, we have not incorporated this in the proposed budget.
It'd be 18-19.
Thank you.
Next budget year. After we're finished with Magnolia and Bell Plain.
Correct. The five-year capital plan envisioned Almond Road being resurfaced, so that was built into the five-year capital plan. But nothing has actually, in the budget presentation we went over today, nothing's been incorporated.
And based on the way that road is torn up right now, because of the JAWA project, which is going to benefit our community too, but, telling people they have to wait a whole nother year before they're going to get relief and it get fixed, and then to be at the mercy of federal funding and it could even get delayed, that's a big risk.
So what are you just recommending?
We're looking for a consensus
the
from
consensus,
the board.
Should then my we go consensus is I'd rather be in control and pay a little bit more. That might be in the long run paying a little less. So I would rather have control so that our residents are not going to be left hanging out there. I mean, they're being inconvenienced enough with the road being torn up. To put it a year or two beyond that just does not seem right. So my vote would be in control.
Trustee Ross?
One other point would be if it was this year where we're cutting back on everything, but we're hopeful that after Key Lime Cove is no longer Key Lime Cove and they start bringing in more money, and that probably we'll have more money to put into capital and be able to do it without worrying. So I would think that as long as it's not this budget year, but next budget year, that makes a difference too.
Yeah, we'll have new retailers online this year. We'll have almost a full year. So, other input, Garner, Hood? Trustee Garner?
I had formulated my question, but basically, so it's basically a situation where we pay a little more to have control, and it's done when we want it done, and that's the end of it, versus go into a bunch of uncertainty and a bunch of unknowns and may not get what we want.
That is correct.
Okay. And this would be done next year?
Correct. My expectation is that if, again, the plan is to resurface the road in the summer of 2018 in its entirety.
When is JAWA supposed to be done with it?
The JAWA project's actually been moving along all winter long because we haven't really had a winter this year. So they're several months ahead of schedule right now. I am cautiously optimistic that they will be doing permanent patching out there early summer of this, this year. And they should be out of there by mid to late summer. The trick there is that patching is only going to be limited to the part that they trench their pipe through. The rest of the road is continuing to deteriorate, and there are a lot of potholes, especially after they moved traffic back and forth several times. And so it's going to be a little more maintenance for our staff once the job is done until we can get the road resurfaced.
Okay. Trustee Hood?
So the number that we're talking about is $830,000 is that we'd save if the grant went through, and is that a true number as best you can tell?
I did my best to quantify everything on there, and I laid out all the details on there. And Patrick mentioned that the staff time, additional staff administration associated with it, I threw a $35,000 number in there to try to quantify what that might be. So I think it accurately reflects what the difference could be if everything falls into place with the scheduling and the timing. I think the worst case scenario is that the timing does not work out, and instead of having this done in one season where I'm attending weekly meetings and our staff is overseeing this project and administering it, now we go into two seasons and we have to double that, and then we have to hire another consultant for another $200,000, and that's the whole scope creep thing that just really makes me uncomfortable.
So the 1.5 already contains the 250 in that? Is that where's the 250?
Negative. The 250 would be under the STP grant, and we would have to expend that today just to get into the process for construction in 2018 under the grant program.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Trustee Wilson?
The federal government's looking at making a huge infrastructure investment. Would this be considered part of that?
Very well could be. We just don't know.
Good chance it's going to get bipartisan support as well in Congress.
Trustee Thornton.
So I'm going to say that I'm in favor of us managing it. The reasons are primarily, I guess, twofold. One, that it's a very heavily traveled road with Woodland Middle School and Warren Almond Campus, with the buses as well as just residents in the area. And two, I think it helps to have it in our control because of all of the roads and the construction that are not in our control with the East Side and the Grand Avenue and the underpass with the train track and all of that. I think it'd be helpful to have this one within our control.
Is that a motion?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, so do I have it sounds like we're in agreement for the most part about controlling our own destiny on this and not using STP. Do I do a motion that way?
Well, I mean, you have it on the agenda.
It's a discussion item.
I mean, you can.
So just direct staff?
Yeah, you can just direct staff.
All right,
and then you would withdraw item number four.
All right. So no one has an objection to directing staff to keep this project in-house. We'll figure it out instead of running the risk of scope creep and timing and other whistles and bells getting added to the project once you're dealing with the federal government. All right.
The other project is going on, so I can't.
Okay. You got direction you need?
Yes, Mayor. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Board of Trustees.
All right, good decision. And so that means we can withdraw item number four because we don't need to put that money out of our pocket right now to see if we would even qualify for federal money. Less hoops to jump to. So do I have to make a motion to withdraw that?
No.
Nope, just withdraw it. All right, that's the end of new business. We don't have to take up the budget again, right? We're done?
No, until the first meeting in April, we'll be back and do a quick run through on the final budget changes and where everything looks like it's going to end up. So.
All right, I'll reopen the floor for public comment. All right, so noted. Do I have a motion to adjourn? Motion by Trustee Bulmes, second by Trustee Garner. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right, we are adjourned.